We have to break the curse by sundown, otherwise this entire town is doomed to repeat the same day over and over again.
Are you seriously telling me you're willing to sacrifice your sister's life for a town full of cowards?
She wants to do true good.
There's a greater good at stake here.
Yeah.
One that I can't just walk away from.
Of course she wants to save her sister.
If you truly expect to be good.
That's exactly what I was saying, you know, last episode? What I was saying. That he's like, oh, I'm good now, all dead. But no. And Fu is telling him this as well. You're not just good because you want to save a person you love. A person who you want to have a romantic relationship with. That doesn't make you a good person. What Fu is doing now, that's what's making you a good person. So, you know, I'm I don't know. Like, I'm really looking forward for that, for Cole to realize that. So, yeah, I'm glad that she told him. And you can see his face. It's like, wait a minute. So, yeah, she has a very good point.
We know you're in there, Bo.
It's about them. The townspeople who stood there and watched me die. The only way is for me to give myself up.
No.
It's okay, Isabel.
You gotta be kidding me. That's the solution? Oh, no, no, no.
They'll kill you.
Maybe.
Yeah, but I still don't know a plan of this. I'm still traumatized from when Phoebe was got burned at the stake. Like, seriously, I really have to see this? So is one of you going to do something?
I want you to beg for mercy.
What are you people doing? Look at him.
Are they going to do something?
He has the courage to fight Setter for all of you. You can't just
this
stand
is too
there
realistic.
And watch him die. You
this
have
is
to
too
do
realistic.
Something.
Nobody crosses me.
I think you just ought to leave Bo alone, Sutter.
You deserve that. Let him suffer a lot, just don't make it too easy.
I'm gonna enjoy this. See you in hell.
Been there, done that.
Just as Angel said. Wow! Okay. No, that's awkward
like I said,
timing.
A demon, always a demon.
Like, I don't even know. But yeah, might even pause. I don't even know what to say. But yeah, I'm just happy, I guess, that at least they're not just like Cole is like 100% good now, and he learned his lesson. No, it's gonna take some time, and yeah, it's definitely in character for him to laugh like that after he burns, you know, a person to death. You know, at least it was rather fast, and it was a pretty shitty person, so. But yeah, still, we can't really just walk around and burn every bad people out there. Well, bad person out there. But Pooh's face kind of said it all. Yeah, it's gonna take a long while before Cole's, gets accepted. You know, assuming he gets accepted. And, you know, I don't even know what to say. I mean, I'm, like, wondering how the interactions are going to evolve. Because he was already, like, very involved now. Very included. I guess what I'm trying to say is, like, and of course I don't want to know because that would be a huge spoiler, but I'm really wondering if he's going to be, like, Leo has been for a long, pretty long time now, like, part of the main cast. Like, is he going to stick around for a while? Like, I'm trying to visualize how it's going to be if he stays for the long term. But yeah, looking forward to finding out, I guess.
Well, I guess I should be going.
Yeah, that would probably be a good idea. You're not going anywhere.
Excuse me,
Phoebe, I don't want to cause any trouble.
What, in front of your sister? No fucks given.
Ah.
What's up with Dad? Why are you still here? What? Okay. So this was episode 14? But yeah, I really enjoyed this episode. I mean, the highlight for me, I think it was pretty obvious, but was the interactions between Cole and Pooh. I didn't expect that. They really have a very nice dynamic. And I don't know, like, at the beginning of the episode, I wasn't too sure. But as soon as Cole and Pooh were sent to that other plane, and they got, like, on the cover with their outfits, it was just awesome. They did the costume, the department did a great job. I like that even though that Pooh was, you know, kind of rightfully mad at Cole about, you know, him trying to kill her, that we still didn't get a too somber tone. It was better, you know, still, like, humor between it, but at the same time, not too much. I can still believe that Pooh was mad at him, but he wants to try to work, you know, together to save Phoebe. And like I mentioned earlier, I really appreciated that she told him again, like, yo, if you want, you know, doing good is more than just that. And he has to understand that you have to be willing to make sacrifice to do good. If he's not going to learn that, if he only is trying to be good for Phoebe, what's going to happen when they break up? You know what I'm saying? The dad also made a return. I mean, objectively speaking, I think he does a great job. The actor is playing their father, and it makes sense that they're including the character again, you know, instead of just disappearing. Subjectively, again, I already mentioned, I don't know, I'm not really... I don't really care for the father. Probably projecting things. I don't know. I'm not really invested into it. But again, from an objective standpoint, I do appreciate it. Yeah, I can be complicated. His scene with Leo were pretty funny. Especially Leo's face, the panic on his face, and I was like thinking, like, oh my god, how am I going to say this? But yeah, I am glad that Leo stood up for himself. Because when the dad got mad, you know, when he was screaming to Leo, like, what are you even doing? And useless and all that, while Phoebe was sort of almost dying, Leo also had enough of it. It was like, no, I am doing something. But at the same time, not too mad. Still, Leo still showing that he understands that their father is scared. But yeah, I mean, again, the highlight for me is Cole and Pooh this episode, and I have to give a lot of props to the actor who plays Cole. He's again very charismatic, really enjoying his character. When he wasn't in the show anymore for season 3, kind of. I did notice, like, I kind of started to miss him. I can't say that I'm a Cole Phoebe shipper as of yet. I mean, at least not that I, you know, noticed that maybe subconsciously. Jesus Christ, I can't talk. But I do really like the character. So, yeah, I think that's kind of it. Like, started to think again if I forgot something. Cowboy. Well, the enemy. Oh, yeah, the enemy. The enemy. So, the Suddert or something. He was right for the plot. Again, we can't always have super charismatic villains. I really didn't like that we had to. I thought it was a little bit too much with, with the whip and, How Bo got slapped repeatedly. I don't know. I really don't like that. I don't want to go into detail why I really don't feel comfortable with that. Maybe you know yourself. I don't want to talk about that. But hey, at least it's a real villain, I guess. You know, he made me feel very mad. It was more real because this villain didn't have magic. And he was also part of the time loop. It's not like he was the one who, was responsible for the time loop. But again, like I said, I really hate it when there's like a horrible curse, a horrible thing, and then the answer is like, oh no, I have to sacrifice myself towards this immense pain so that other people can learn a lesson, or like I can learn a lesson even though I already learned a lesson because I realized it at that moment. It's just horrible. I don't really feel any sympathy for the townspeople. Yeah, at the last second, one of them decided to save him, but it was already too late for me. I mean, good for you, you're out of your time loop, but I'm still shook. And yeah, I know, maybe you're like, Marley, you see it a little bit too black or white. If you're in the same shoes, you also wouldn't dare to step up for him. But, you know, this is how real life, this is a show, so I can complain. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to more episodes where we're going to a certain time period, whether that's literally going back into time, or just as they were doing now to different planes. You know, with introducing this, it is easier for the writers to just write more episodes for different time periods without them really going back into time. So yeah. Alright, thank you so much for watching. Bye.